Let's spice it up a little bit today. All right. I'm trying to see. So, I'm going to sound like a typical fitness person, but first, I only do one takes, and normally I do one thing, but I wanted to make sure. I'm testing on a new Fuji lens, because the other one was getting too dark in the other videos for all my millions of subscribers out there and viewers. This one will be rated, whatever you want to call it, PG-13, rated R, because there will be some cursing, that's about it. So this was just to test out the Fuji thing, and so far it's doing okay. But I'm going to sound like a typical fitness person for, I got to rant about this. You know, if you're in the, not just the gym mirror, but you're in the mirror and you're like, you look so good, you know, man, you look great. But then you watch it on the video, I'm like, man, I have like no shoulders. My shoulders are ginormous. It's amazing how different you look on camera than you do in the mirror or even in pictures. You know, it just still amazes me. And this is not my, I'm not a, like a techie in this part, so I don't understand what happens. But I know I look like shit, but I also am 45. So for 45, you know, I look like shit to me. Really don't look like that bad. So the goal for, before I tell my birthday wishes, so today's April 5th, and this was supposed to be my fitness expo, but luckily, even before all this fucking shit hit the fan with the stupid fucking COVID-19, what was it, October of last year, I canceled it because it was, you know, we were signing up, not just because it wasn't me, it was just people, all the people that own the supplement companies and everything were like, dude, expos are dead. Well, fuck, they're dead now. So luckily that happened because we'd be out 15, 20, 30, 50 grand that I could not recover from the rentals and everything like that. So the goal was to be like at least 245, because I weighed in at almost 266 today. The goal was to be 245, dry as fuck, and it was looking pretty good, because about 2 weeks ago I was low 260s, and then I went back up to 270 about 2 weeks ago, but I still had, I mean, nobody would believe me, striations in the chest, veins popping out everywhere, I mean, abs were really coming in, the gut was still huge, but at least I had the abs coming in. But I mean, it's amazing when you fall off the diet, wow, how quickly it goes away. But this week, I fucking diabetes galore. I mean, I can show you. I'm eating so much junk food. No steak, no pork this week. I think I had a little bit of chicken and fish, which I never eat chicken and fish. So I had maybe like a pound a day of protein. Just pure shit. And it has nothing to do with the homeschooling or anything like that. It's just, I was just like, fuck it. It's my birthday. I'll get it back. It'll take me a few weeks, but I'll be looking half decent again. So 45, 55 inch chest, almost 19 inch arms, gut's huge. It's huge. I can still squeeze in a 33 jeans though. I'm like, you know, remember our sisters and all. So 18 and a half inch calves, 27 inch quads, which I really want the legs to get smaller and smaller and smaller. So there's all my fitness excuses, right? Now, talking about family. For my birthday wish, I mean, I really do, there's really not much to complain about. I have a totally awesome fucking life. I really do. My son gave me a lollipop, now I'm chewing on the stick. I actually love my wife. My wife actually loves me. Really don't ever fight. She's, my only issue has always been, and well, it wasn't in the 90s, it was just financially, with all the girls I dated, whatever. But my wife, her only complaint is I'm not a bazillionaire. But isn't that everybody's complaint? Because how many of us are really, you know, Jeff Bezos or something like that that are, or real money, you know what I mean, they're actually loaded. So anyway, we don't ever really fight. Which, wow, not even like, say, when we grew up, whose parents weren't trying to kill each other 24/7. And even nowadays, I know a lot of friends are like, fuck, man, all we do is fight. I just hate my wife. My wife hates me, blah, blah, blah. So I'm grateful for that. That I'm like, I consider the one percenters that actually get along with my wife and kids. I'm trying not to do my typical rant, but it's so hard. Kids, I'm actually loving the homeschooling thing. I mean, I think I'm one of the only people in the world that love it. But I enjoy being with my kids, and it really pisses me the fuck off when people are like, you know, oh man, it's just fucking bullshit, and your kids, blah, blah, blah. Oh, it's, trust me, being an old man and being back in school, oh, trust me, it fucking sucks. But it's being with the kids. Now, it's a little easier for me because I'm a stay-at-home dad. So, but I'm one of the few people that actually enjoy it. And right now, my kids are almost 7 and a little bit over 2. They're, you know, they love me. Because you know how when kids get teenagers or adults, usually, you know, that goes to the wayside. So, the purpose of this was, I don't know if you mentioned, was to test out the new lens I got for the Fuji camera. And so far, it's working pretty good. The other one was too dark. So this one, we can play with. I really want to be back in Pennsylvania. PA, Pensy, because PA is what most of us Dutchies call it. As far as, you know, everybody knows, like, Stouty and Tromey and, well, Brentzinger's down here, but since my dad forced us to leave when I was in high school, I've been wanting to come back. And, it, you know, if people that know it, it's really hard when you move out of an area or whatever, you know, you give up the jobs, businesses or whatever, it's really hard. So every year, everybody's hearing forever and ever. And this year was looking really good with the businesses. And then one business died, but now the meat business is looking good. So now I'm going to say 2021, we'll be living in Pensy. But it'll be more Wayne, where my grandfather grew up. Really liked that area. Always liked it when I was growing up. And it sucks he's not alive. He died a few months ago, and it really sucks. Didn't spend much time with him growing up. For many different reasons. So really like the Wayne area. Oh, trust me, I loved it. I'd still love Topton and Dole Mountain and all of the whole Pennsylvania Dutch area. And didn't we just have a fucking awesome time growing up? Because I guess most of the people watching this, hopefully be the few people that follow me on Facebook or whatever, but I guess maybe I should make this. So obviously you know how old I am. So growing up 70s and 80s and 90s in Pennsylvania was just the best. We went to Brandywine. For middle high school, I went to Long Swamp. Just a totally awesome area. Really no issues, right? There was really no issues growing up. No bullying, no nothing. I just really loved it, and I miss it. And because I'm in shithole Florida. You know, you send your kids.